This is my last talk,
I think. If you didn't see him, it's too bad. It will not happen again.
Except right now.
Not this year. Yeah. Oh, and the challenge. Go ahead.
Yeah, so some of you know, at least like seven of you know, that we did this SCM challenge, and I was one of several people. So it was Phil Nash, who was just up here, did one of these puzzles. I did one of these puzzles. I actually completely missed when they gave out the iPad to a randomly selected winner. And that was a random selection. Here are the three that I consider honorable mentions. You don't get iPads. Number one, Tai Meng. Very simple. Just the problem was print out numbers that go, print out a series of numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to N, and then back down to 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But you have to do it without repeating any identifiers in your entire program text. So the first step, write a tokenizer that pulls out all the identifiers and make sure they're all unique, and then second step, operate under that constraint. So this made it hard because you couldn't do loops or you know, you couldn't do more than one loop, you couldn't do a loop that mentioned the name of a variable twice, you couldn't have a function and then call it, things like that. But it turned out you didn't actually need any of this, and someone figured that out. Yeah, so C out, and then that's just the literal string. And it's got spaces in between, and then on the way down it has tabs in between. T78 is a different identifier from 78. Yeah, that works. Yeah, sorry about that, all right. And he explicitly mentioned the magic number 652, which was in fact the biggest number you could put in that wouldn't break the grader. But there were some other people who tried to solve it in interesting ways as well, to try to smuggle in a non-trivial program, right? One that didn't just print, but could do for arbitrary n based on a loop. This one from Michael Kazakov. He actually contacted me on Slack afterward and wanted to know, was there a way to do it that wasn't so hacky? Yeah. And then we have Richard Smith, the Richard Smith, who takes great delight in breaking everyone's puzzles. Submitted this. So those are my three honorable mentions. And I have 2 minutes left, so I'm just gonna evangelize a little bit. Everyone read this slide and internalize it. An allocator is a handle to a heap. I see Marshall there. Marshall, internalize this. Internalize this. An allocator is not a source of memory. An allocator is a pointer to a source of memory. A container contains a pointer to a source of memory. The source of memory is separate from the container. It's separate from the allocator. The allocator is contained within the container. You can have an allocator that's not in a container. You can have an allocator that's not a heap. It's merely a handle to a heap. Allocator types should be copyable. This has always been true. It's still true. They should be copyable just like pointers. This was always true. Now it's more obvious. They should be cheaply copyable. Memory resource type should be immobile. That's all the slides I have. Oh, yeah. What about std allocator? Yeah, it works. Ask a mathematician. Internalize this. That's not even my lightning talk. My first lightning talk was all this stuff. Let me show this again.